And we're live. And we're live. Doing it live. Doing it live. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome, welcome. Klezmezers, right at the top of the hour. How's it going, man? It's just you and me, baby. Right on time, dude. Well, 2 minutes late. Yo, 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 yo. Check, check. We got, little sound. We got Matt Young. We got Matt Young, Dan Borgo, Xavier33. What's up? NMM. What's good? Know How. Evan Tarr from New York. Cast Beats. What's good? What's good? What's good? So later on, I want to pull off a little raid later, because Matty J has a stream going on crosstown. It's really great, and I just want to check that out. Thought maybe we'll go raid her Twitch stream later. Yeah. Yo, that was a fun stream the other night, listening to jazz records and you reacting to McCoy and stuff. I loved it. Thanks, GW91. Yeah, I think we'll be doing more and more of that. That'll be a thing that happens. Yo, Keith, do you listen to a lot of saxophonists? If so, who's your favorite? I do. I really like John Coltrane. I like Wayne Shorter. I like Dexter Gordon. I like Hank Mobley. On trumpet, I like Lee Morgan. I like I love Freddie Hubbard. Art Farmer, Donald Byrd, lots of guys. Lots and lots of guys. On saxophone, on alto, I really like, obviously, Charlie Parker. Cannibal Adderley is one of my favorites. I like Jackie McLean. Yeah, lots of different saxophone players. Yeah, anyway, so I got a little beat up here I just started a few minutes ago. Just some drums going here. Hold up, let me make sure that y'all can even hear this. Looks like y'all can. Cool. Rest in peace, Lee Morgan. Yeah. I mean, yeah. Rest in peace, Lee Morgan. I'm pretty sure, yeah. Yeah, Lee Morgan died in like the 70s. And he actually was murdered by his wife on stage while performing. Pretty crazy. Yeah. Pretty wild. So we got a little beat that I started here. I really like these drums a lot. I think they're nice and gritty. Just to cut up some breaks, you know. I'm just gonna call this drums, and these are this little hat loop. I think I want it faster. No. No, back to where it was. Pretty much like it there. Yeah, Lee Konitz passed away, actually, so that's a really important musician to acknowledge at this time. Yeah, Lee Konitz passed away yesterday from COVID. That was sad news. I wish I could say more about Lee Konitz, but I didn't actually listen to him a whole lot, but I do understand his importance in the music. Just an incredible horn player. And I know that his passing means a lot to a lot of different people. So if you're not familiar, you know, I encourage you to, you know, go check out his music. And yeah, Lee Konitz, man. Yeah, it's been rough, dude. There's been a lot of these. There's been Oh, that's interesting. Oh, dude. Oh, never mind. Thought I had a realization. Never mind. Yeah, I know it's been a tough couple of months in the jazz world. Wallace Roney passed away. Ellis Marsalis passed away. There's lots of others. I mean, obviously McCoy passed away, but I don't believe that was from COVID. But nonetheless, it's been a lot of people passing on. So it's been I know a lot of tough news to get through for a lot of people. But you know, we honor them, we listen to them, and you know, I think that's the best way to move forward. You know, let me see if I got a little piano sound going here. It appears I do not. Oh, hold up. Hold the phone. I need to plug this in. Okay. On a brighter note, Richard Davis turned 90 recently. Oh, wow. That's dope. Yeah. Have you ever played with Chris Dave? Yes, I have. I've gotten to play with Chris Dave more than a few times, actually. Is that coffee on your shirt? No, actually, I spilled jam on it. And it just never washed out. And I kind of fuck with it, actually. Yeah, the lick? What's the lick? The lick is this combination of notes that everyone always talks about. But then everyone thinks people think everything is the lick when it's not. Like they'll hear like this they'll be like, oh, it's the lick. And it's like, nah, it's just those three notes at the end that sounded the same. And those three notes are like extremely common. So they always think that it's the lick. So then I always get really annoyed. People are like, oh, dude, you played the lick. I'm like, no, I did it. And even if I did, dude, I'm gonna play it anyways. Yeah. So that's the lick. It's like a little, it's a lick, you know? Just gonna keep adjusting my level here. Cool. Just wanted to tell you guys something because I realized the last time I wasn't responding to certain things, and then I just kind of wanted to tell you guys why. And then in the future, I think we'll just avoid any sort of awkwardness. You know, one of the things I'm doing on the show is I'm making music the way I would normally make it in case people are interested. And if you're not interested, that's fine. I guess you know that's totally okay. I'm totally open to that as a concept that I'm not the most interesting thing in the world. That's fine. I'm still going to do this regardless. But I'm not going to be taking suggestions on how to make it because I'm still going to make the music the way I want to make it. That's really important to me. Now, if I need help, I might ask some questions like, yo, what should I put here? By all means, help me when I do that. But if you're telling me like, oh, make this, make that, make this, make that, I'm not going to do it. Now, if you have a question, of course, I'm happy to help. Hey, how do you do this? How do you do this? You know, could you, if you ask the question like, hey, could you show maybe how you do this or how you do that? Happy to do it. But if you're sitting there like, hey, turn down the hi-hat, I'm not gonna do that, okay? I mean, I might, but I might just ignore your thing. So I'm just letting y'all know, just to avoid any kind of like awkward, like me being like, no. I'm just saying that ahead of time. I make music the way that I make it. And I think yeah, it's just that's what I'm doing on the show. I also do take lessons from people and ask them how to do things. But the show is not when that is happening. But I might ask, if I ask your help, please help me, by all means. I'm also open to that. That could happen. Okay, anyway. So I'm going to keep going. Just want to let y'all know that I'm not going to be making something other than how I'm going to make it. You know what I mean? Okay, cool. Dude, lately I've been doing this thing where I record things twice as fast, and then I put a bunch of like crazy effects on them, and then I slow them down, you know? It seems that you like closed voicings. I mean, yeah, I like open voicings, I like closed voicings, I like drop twos, I like drop threes, I like block chords, I like all kinds of voicings. All kinds of voicings. I mean, in this case, I'm actually not playing a closed voicing. That's open. But yeah, I do like closed voicings. They're very important. Okay. Okay. I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to record this at double speed. I'm going to slow it down. Check it out. All right, here we go. Actually, yeah, yes. Okay. This will be hard. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Check this out. Now, the reason why I'm doing this is after I apply some processing to it, and then you pitch it down an octave, it'll take the processing with it, and it'll make it sound as if you, it'll sound like sampled audio. This is a trick. This is an Illmind trick. How do you decide whether it should be released or not? If it's my favorite, I mean, if my favorite 10 or so, that's what makes the album. You know, I don't really overthink it. It's really not a complicated thing for me. But honestly, like, a song is done when it's like 90% of what it could be. You know, the most important thing is that it feels like me. My goalpost is this perfect or not. It has more to do with if I feel like, if I love it, if it feels like it's me, you know. That's kind of cool. Fuck it. I'll make two of these just so that so I can show you the difference. Oh, you know what? Oh, I should have kept the old one. Well, whatever. All good. All right, cool. Now check this out. So now I'm gonna this is an Illmind trick that I got from my friend Cal Banks. Showed this to me. Cal? Yeah, Cal showed this to me. He got this from Illmind, I believe. Really cool trick. And you hit repitch. And now I'm gonna put it back to where it was. That's a sick sound. Someone said that music composition is like a language. The more you do it, the more fluent you get. It seems like you've spent a lot of time composing music. I agree with that, and thanks. I appreciate that. Yeah, this sounds crazy because it took the processing with it, you know. But to do that, I had to play it twice as fast, so it's kind of tough. How was your process of learning new voicings? Was it mainly transcribing? Did you? No. My process of learning voicings actually did not involve a lot of transcribing. That came from my teachers giving me suggestions on how to do things, and then just playing things over and over and over and over and over again. You know, just playing those voicings in all 12 keys over and over and over. Yeah. So what I did was I played it twice as fast, because if you drop it in an octave, or rather if you cut the speed in half, it'll drop an octave. So I recorded at double speed up an octave from where I wanted it, and because I wanted it to sound like a slow, it sounds like it's in slow motion, right? I mean, it's like really trippy. But then I also, before I slowed it down to get the slow motion effect, I also put some processing on it first, and froze it, and then I pitched it down. So that way it took, you know, the tape flutter and all of that. So it literally sounds like slowed down tape. Also with the repitch thing, you won't hear as much warping, because it doesn't actually really warp the audio. It just stretches it. So there's no like weird like or like weird buzzy ringy sounds that you get from like, you know, like I'll put this on texture. Yeah, like Well, I guess that's technically okay. I'd have to put a minus 12 to get the same. Although actually it might, because I slowed down the tempo, it might actually sound the same. Yeah. But if I did that at the same speed and then pitched it down, you wouldn't get the same thing. You get like these types of stretches like that. Bow three pitch. Yeah. Oh, and we have some subscribers that I haven't been playing for. So let me just acknowledge them really quick. We got Sleuth1. Thank you so much for subscribing. It's my honor to have you here. I hope I make you proud. I'm trying to do the best that I can. And I hope it's entertaining as well. Name Backwards has subscribed as well. Using Twitch Prime. I hope that you stay with us, and I hope I make you proud as well. Starting with that little success line that I play on the road, so hopefully that was well done. And also, Found My Bread. Oh, and would you look at that? We have a hype train. The hype train has started. We are on fire today. I'm going to start up the monopoly. Yo, we might have to make an album, because I think what I've been making on these streams has been really good stuff. On level 2 of the hype train. Can you tell us how you made the lead on What a Day? I'm pretty sure it's probably just a that was a bunch of things. Right, I could listen to that really quick. Okay, wait, yeah. Let me check this out really quick. Let's see how many streams we're at. 1.4, not bad. Yeah, that's like five different things. That's like there's a bell sound that I think came from, oh man, when did I make the I don't even remember. Let's see. I made that in, no, I couldn't have used the Kronos for that. Maybe I did. Yeah, I think I might have had a bell sound on the Kronos, some DX7 sounds, like a flute sound. This is a bunch of DX presets. All presets, dude. And then I played a bunch of, like, it's all in forest, you know? It's a bunch of an octave down. It's like eight different things playing the same line. This part, this is like a flute. This is a Kronos piano tone underneath the, or like an octave higher than the flute. And then another flute, the DX flute, also an octave up. Yeah, there's like three different things. Synth sound in Most Beautiful Girl, probably the DX7. Although I think the only synths there were pads in the background. Because that's just Rhodes, piano, bass, guitar, and drums. And then there's like a pad, like at the end. Yeah, that's not a synth, that's a Rhodes. It's just been pitched around. The only pads is like at the end. Well, the only synths are at the end, you know. All those tiny pads, super high up. Anyway, alright, I'm gonna put a bass line down. Put the DX bass sound for this. Shabby. Okay. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Shouts all the new subs. Thanks so much, Supreme Tortilla, for helping me out with that. I like how it's called What a Day, but you had to try and remember what happened on that day. Yeah, I know. Well, yeah, no, I don't remember always. But, I mean, it's always the same things. Like, it's always, like, I play my instruments, you know. I play my DX7, my piano, my Kronos, my Monopoly, Rhodes, my CS10, my Moog Model D, or my clone. It's not the actual Moog Model D, you know. So, yeah, let's check out this bass part. But first, I think I'm going to expand this out to How do I program the bass sound in the Monopoly? You know what? If I knew the answer to that, I would do it. But for some reason, I'm struggling with that thing right now, and I don't know why. Oh, wait, I'm such a fool. I just realized there's a switch on here. Oh, I'm such an idiot. Okay. Okay. I mean, so... Oh, wait, no, I'm not an idiot. Wait a minute. Yeah, I mean, you can do it, you know, like any other synth, you know, there's no rules, inherent rules for bass tone, you know, you just gotta find the tone that you like. But as with most synths, you have a oscillator and a filter, usually. And the oscillator will pick the tone. Like if you have a sawtooth or a square or whatever. Monopoly, let me see what they have. I never remember what these are called. Yeah, it's got like a triangle and a sawtooth. And it's got a couple other things. I don't actually know what they're called because I'm hella ignorant. But and so you can select the tone there, and you can select the octave. You got four oscillators, so you can combine them however you want. And then you can detune them if you want them, like to have a slight, like almost like a chorus type of sound. And then you have your filter, and then you have your envelope. So, you know, just using those things, you know, you can come up with the tone that you like. The envelope is the shape of the loudness over time. So if you want to fade in, like, and then fade down, you know, versus boom, right, where it is a really fast attack, or you can go boom, right, really, like almost no decay, or a long decay rather, you know, you got to look up envelopes, filters, you got to know what resonance means, you should know what cutoff means, and then you should combine those two concepts to understand what the filter envelope means, and just using those simple parameters, you can start coming up with bass tones, or any synth tone for that matter, not any synth tone, but a bunch of different purposes, I guess. Keith, how tall are you? I'm 6'1". 6 foot. Oh, and my basketball measurement is 6'1", but I'm actually 6 foot. Basketball measurement just means like if you were to lie about it, you know, how tall would you say you are? Okay, here we go. Thank you. Quick, the monopoly. Yeah, did you say that he has a, this bass was on the DX7. This is just a preset. Hand length stats though. Yeah, no, I don't have very big hands. My hands are like reasonably sized, but they're not that big. Wish I had bigger hands. It'd make, you know, playing a little bit easier. Oops, put two of these on. Okay, here we go. Thank you. pretty. I'm using RC20 so much today, and I don't give a fuck, dude. I don't care, dude. I like RC20 because it's easy to use. You know? Tomato, tomato. What up, dude? Tomato, tomato. What up? Merman Music, what's good? What's up, y'all? Yo, if you're in the chat, make yourself known. Say what's up. If you're just watching, feel free to follow. If you're following, feel free to subscribe. It's time to flatten, baby. And please say what's up to Knowledge, okay? Say what's up, big homies here, okay? Gotta give them respect, okay? I don't know if I'd have a job if it wasn't for Knowledge, okay? He opened up a lane, okay? Along with a lot of other producers out there, but he's certainly one of them who helped open up this lane. So say what's up, give him the respect he deserves, because on this channel, we fuck with Knowledge, okay? And if you don't fuck with Knowledge, I'm not good at saying anything menacing, but I would right now, okay? So that's where we're at. Yeah, you know what? I am down with that. Let's throw some emotes in there real quick. Bam. Oh, that's perfect because I got the Knowledge gat. There we go. That's what happens if you don't fuck with Knowledge in this. In this Twitch stream. And that's where we're at. Okay, let's just listen to this right now. See where we're at. Should we also take this down an octave, but this time not do the repitch thing? Let's see what that sounds like. Actually, hold up. What happens here? Yeah, let's do that. Let's make these transitions a little cleaner. Dwee. Ooh. Thank you. just consolidate. Which I got to be honest is a word I did not understand before using Ableton, but then soon realized it's a very useful vocabulary term, and I should have known it because it's very widely used. Great word, consolidate. Means to consolidate. So here we go. We're just going to bump this down. I wonder what this sounds like down an octave. Ooh, you know what? Dude, actually, low key, up a fifth? Down a fifth. No. Down a fourth. Up a fifth, down an octave. Yeah, let's do that. Ooh. Did this work? I'm not sure. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna have both, dude. We're gonna have both. And one's gonna be... Ooh, what does down an octave sound like, by the way? Also, did you hear how I just clicked my teeth and it made such an amazing cross-stick sound, dude? God. Okay. Up there. Ooh. Oh, man. Dude, Ivan, welcome, dude. Welcome to the stream, dude. You stumbled into the right place, dude. Oh, and by the way, dude, we're headed towards 200 subscribers. By the way, I mean, shouts to the followers, too, okay? Now, you guys are not paying me, but it's all good, okay? Because I'd be doing this regardless, which I am. Doing it regardless, pretty much. I haven't even seen the payday yet. Doesn't matter. The point is, thanks for being here. We got 100... Ooh, excuse my my French there. 1,667 followers. Which, considering we're about 3 weeks deep, is a tremendous honor. Doesn't go unnoticed. I don't take an ounce of this for granted, because I play piano, dude. Okay? I'm not even supposed to have a career. Alright? Sorry, that was cynical. But... you know it's a joke, but also not taking it for granted. 153 subscribers. Now, that is where I'm especially thankful. Thank you guys so much for offering me some funds as we're trying to learn together and grow together. But we do have a goal in mind. We got big goals in mind, okay? We are headed towards 200 subscribers. That's the goal. And when we hit 200 subscribers, that will unlock... the Discord, okay? And when the Discord happens, it's lit, okay? When the Discord happens, you guys can tune in there, if you're tier 3, anyways. If you sign up tier 3, you'll have access to the Discord. I'm going to figure out how this works. I don't know how it's going to work. We're going to figure it out. And then on said Discord, we'll be able to chat together. You'll be able to send me your music. I'll listen to it, tell you what I think, give you whatever support I can, and we can just hang out there. We'll do some voice calls. I also kind of want to do, like, some giant, like, movie-watching parties. Like, we can just, I'll have, like, private Zoom parties. We'll just, you know, hop in there, and we'll just hang. And it's going to be great. It's going to be nice. Ivan, welcome. SubjectNo3TV, welcome, welcome. Found my bread, Kles Mezers. What's good, dude? Thank you. filtered down one over here. But I want this to be... Dude, it's so funny making music on Ableton using Dre Beats, which are like the worst headphones, but no, they're great headphones, but not for like mixing, you know, not that I'm mixing right now, but it's just kind of a funny thing to do, because I'm just getting super messed up mix. Okay. Too bass heavy. Yeah, I feel like Beats headphones just make the bass a little louder than it actually is. Yeah, they like boost the bass a little bit. They're consumer headphones. Like consumer headphones are not doing the job that mixing headphones would do. Mixing headphones are supposed to sound honest. They're supposed to reveal the things that don't sound good in your mix by reflecting them honestly, whereas consumer headphones like Beats headphones are supposed to make things sound good. You don't want to mix on something that sounds good, because then it's like trying to paint with rose-colored glasses, like glasses that make everything look amazing, and you paint this incredible thing, like, wow, looks great. Or like, you know, yeah, like, wow, looks great, and then you take the glasses off and like, wow, this looks like shit. Like, you know, that's in the simplest terms I can put it, why you don't want to mix with consumer headphones. Although, well, you do, but you generally, you don't want them to be the main thing. You want to have, like, if you're going to mix in headphones, you should have mixing headphones. Now, that being said, when I'm mixing, I also do consult with my consumer headphones and also my car stereo, everything. I listen to a mix on a ton of different things to get a general feeling of how everything sounds on all the different systems. Although, honestly, when I'm at that point, I'm usually not changing anything anyways. But like, unless something drastic, like it just sounds terrible in my car stereo, like unless something drastic happens, I'm probably not gonna do anything at that point. Usually it's already mixed fine because I'm using my mixing monitors. Oh, by the way, dude, I love my mixing monitors. All I have are M-Audio BX8s. Simple. Are they fancy? No. Are they the best? No. Do they get the job done? Yes. Because I know them very well, and I generally know how things are going to sound elsewhere because I know my monitors very well. Yeah. Okay. Here we go. Let's run it back, dude. Okay. I need to do something else here, dude. This is a nice little beat. Let's do something else. Maybe we can play some piano. Maybe we can listen to some beats. Maybe I can make another one. Just make another idea. Yeah, let's make another idea. Dude, lately I've been doing this thing. And by lately, I mean, hold up. It's crazy how I can hear what's happening in the other room through this tiny little microphone. It's not a tiny microphone, but it's not, certainly not omnidirectional, so I'm impressed that that it's picking that up in the other room. Kind of tripping out. HS5's nice. HS7, nice. Anyone have those Atom audio monitors? Oh, you know who does? Matty J does. Wait, hold up. Yo. Should we raid? Dude, we're gonna raid, dude. Let's raid, dude. Dude, we're gonna start a raid, dude. We're doing it. We're gonna raid Maddie J now. Oh shit, y'all ready to raid, dude? Let's do it. We're doing it. Shall we? We're gonna raid Maddie J now, dude. So everyone say what's up, hit follow. Dude, I wanted to get 50 followers from us, okay? We're not doing this unless we're doing this. Are we doing this? Are we doing this right now? Dude, is Jaybird here, dude? Jaybird's here, dude. What a legend. Jaybird's an amazing keyboardist, producer, and outstanding guy as well. Yeah, dude. Okay, we're going to raid Maddie J now, okay? And I want to get at least all of you to hit follow because she's dope and she's awesome. Let's go. Bam. Oh, shit. We're doing it, baby. Whoa. Are we doing it? Are we there? Dude, I can't even see anything. I don't even know what's going on. Woo! Did it happen? I have no idea what's happening right now, dude. This shit is mad confusing, dude.
Yeah, I think you have another one here. What was that? What else did I say? Maybe a little bit. I think this could be like a 2:20. I'm always trying to like hit under 3 minutes and like say everything I want to say. Like your ultimate goal should be to say everything you want to say with a song, but after that, length is not a goal. So, oh yeah. Also, if you know any guitar players, I think this could be super tight if you got someone to play the guitar line. Because you're just using samples right now. I don't know if you like played it and then you sampled it. Maybe you're a guitar player. I don't know you. Maddie should rate the beat Kiefer just produced on stream. Send it to me. Kiefer, send it to me. I'll give you some feedback. Send me your track. I'll give you some validation. Please. okay, sorry. Back to this. This is Flo Kelly Beats, and big takeaways. Try some different bass notes, maybe a different bass. Or just do you. I don't know. Maybe try some guitar. You could have some like nice little guitar fills. Some like musical growth. I'm gonna text him, tell him to send me his beat. Send me the beat. I don't know if you can, if you just made it, you'll have to bounce it and stuff, but also my favorite vocal tone is at the beginning here when you come in. And then it changes a bunch, but like right when it comes in here. I love that filtered sound. Okay, I don't know if Kiefer's gonna send me anything, but yeah. Okay, that's all I had notes on. I'm gonna kind of wrap it up a little bit. There's one beat that I got sent that I really liked that I had no notes on, but I was gonna use it as like an outro. Where is it? Andrew Twining. I just thought this was really nice. There's also more Kiefer's wheelhouse. Yeah, if you send me release music, I just honestly, I needed to like have some sort of like, I just had to get through all of them in some way, filter it in some way. And I just feel like it's cooler when like I can give you feedback and like you can actually use it. So, yeah. Should we just keep listening to Andrew Twining till Kiefer gets here? Do you guys like my iTunes visualizer? Yeah, I'm going for like a 2000s like Mac. I'm using like the Mac font, like I don't know. Maybe you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna write the names of the people. It messes with the stream. Oh no. I kinda like how it's glitching out like that. I'm based in LA. Yes, I am. I'm in LA right now as we speak. Oh, back to Wait, there was another one that I liked that I also didn't know what to say. Let's go to that. What's the purpose of your visit? This guy. This song. Oh, here we go. Kiefer sent it. Let's do this. Yeah, I got it. My goodness, my audio driver just like crashed. Oh my god. Kiefer, I'm sorry you crashed my audio driver or something. I don't know what happened. Okay. This is hot. Okay, we're getting rid of the iTunes visualizer. About this is these little parts. I think when people are starting out and they're producing, it's like, okay, we gotta get some chords. Okay, we got the chords. And then like, okay, some bass. Like we got our bass, that's cool. We got, oh, obviously the drums, like usually people are starting with drums, but like these little details, like the like parts are really like the coolest things you can do. Like parts, not just chords. Not just a groove, but like a melody that you can like sing, you know? Also, yeah, why are you a better bass player than me? Keyboard player. Like, you can still sing. if this was like something somebody was gonna sing over, like you could still do that. You know, you could still sing over that. It could just be in the background, as a part. My Teen Town cover. Yeah, I took it down because people were being mean to me on the internet. People are so mean on YouTube. I love Keith's parts. Yeah, I love Keith's parts. They're amazing. Keith's too fire. All right, y'all. I'm sorry my stream kept cutting out. I don't know how to fix that, but I'll get it ready for next time. If you wanna do another one of these, just make sure you stay tuned to my socials, and I'll do another call for submissions, if you want to call them that. And I do this every Sunday, Thursday. Sometimes I'm making beats. Sometimes I'm doing this, apparently. So come back. And yes, I am making more shirts. Oh, I got a new color. You want to see? I did a different color this time. So yeah, these are coming out probably in like a week or so. I'll be done. Why can't I hold it? For those of you who don't know, I've been silk screening merch in my apartment during quarantine. So, okay, wrapping it up. Thank you guys. This has been super, super fun. See you another time. See you another time. See you.
And we're back. Okay, so we made it back from Maddie's. It was a fun ride. It was cool. Thanks so much for sticking with it. Okay, since we're here, figured we might as well do a few questions if you guys are interested, and then just calling it. I'll get the piano out just in case. Actually, I don't know if I want to play some piano. Oh, I might play a little piano. You never know. Why is it letting me pull up VMPK? Cool. Oh, and we're still doing that. Let me just click out of Ableton 2 before my shit completely explodes. Actually, let's listen to it one more time. You guys, today was a great day as far as getting new people on the team. We got 160 subscribers. I remember last time we had like 120, so somehow in the last 2 days we got like 40 subscribers or some shit. And we're almost at the 200 subscriber goal. So thank you so much for tuning in. Of course, as stated before, after 200 subscribers, I will unlock the Discord, which at the time of its, you know, unlockingness, it'll only be available to tier 3. However, if you're not in the Discord, if you're not on tier 3, all good, lots of stuff. Tier 1 and tier 2 get their own treats as well. Tier 1, you'll have access to any sort of learning materials that are created here. A lot of these episodes, I'm transcribing stuff. I'm making charts. The other day, I was asked to break down this Highest Coyote song. We did that. I was also asked to do a Yusef Day's track, I believe. Or was it a... I don't remember. Yusef Day's track, we did that. There was some Robert Glasper stuff people asked me about. I chart them out, and then I send them to you guys. Oh, the diagram, I forgot. Okay, I'll send you guys the diagram tonight if you're a subscriber. And then tier 2, you guys will get access to, like, you know, unreleased music, I think. For everyone else, the followers, you know, I really appreciate you guys being here. There should be some sort of giveaways. I think I'm going to do some giveaways. That would be fun. You know what? Fuck it. We're going to do some giveaways, and regardless of whether or not you're a follower or a subscriber, everyone's eligible. I should send somebody some signed vinyl or something. That'd be really fun. Yeah. And so we're just creating a little community here where I can interact with you guys. We can talk about cool shit. We can get better at harmony. We can make beats. And yeah, that's the objective. So... Oh, and you know what? It's happy hour, baby. I don't give a fuck. It's time for a little bit of whisk. Oh, shit. It's quarantine, dude. It's always happy hour during quarantine. Tip for transcribing by ear after you get the top line and bass. Those notes in the middle are super tricky. Yeah, for me, I really just listen for quality. So, one thing you have to learn when you... ear train is what a major triad sounds like, you know. Starting, you know, simple as that. Let me figure out my color palette here. Cool. You know, when you hear a major triad, you should know what that is. You should know that it's major. There's actually a website. If you go to musictheory.net. It's really just basic ear training exercises can be great. But this one's called chord ear training. And this is basically the same idea. Now, without knowing what it is, I'm not trying to figure out, oh, is there a C on the bottom? Or is there an A on top? I don't care about that. I'm just trying to hear the quality. And I can hear that that's a diminished triad. Bam. Another diminished triad. That's a major triad. That's a diminished triad. That's an augmented triad. That's a diminished triad. Augmented triad. Minor triad. Right? And so just hearing the quality, that's one. Now, more than just triads, you also want to be able to do, you know, seventh chords. Now, I like doing these separate because sometimes you can't tell if it's four notes, you know. I'll do some seventh chords. Augmented major seven. Ooh. Wait, what's an augmented seventh mean? What does augmented seventh mean? Does that just mean like a sharp? Okay, so that's like a... Okay, cool. So, yeah, let's put all the seventh chords in here and see if I can do these. So we got the fundamental seventh chords with just flat sevenths or major sevens, major thirds, and... Yeah, okay, cool. Then we've got half diminished and diminished, augmented and augmented major. Cool, yeah. That's a minor seven. That sounds like an augmented seven. Fifo do do minor 7. That's a diminished 7. Sounds like augmented major 7. That sounds like a minor major 7. And so, like, those type of exercises, you know, where you can practice hearing qualities. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing 8 of these at once. You know, I would probably start simple. Do the triads first. Then do just dominant, major, and minor 7. Then add the minor major 7. And so on and so forth. Those are really good. Also, while that's happening, you know, interval ear training is good. That's all unison. Bum, bum, unison. Oops, octave. I forgot octave was there. Do-do, right. Why am I getting so many octaves and unisons? You know, so you really want to make sure you have all the intervals down as well. And then the one that I do a lot is this one, where it's just, you know, it gives you a note. You guess what it is. Things like that can be really helpful. And then, of course, like, you know, singing things all the time. Like, you know, make sure you can sing this, you know. Oh, now, of course, now it thinks I'm playing. Okay. So be able to guess, you know. You know. There was this exercise we did in high school where you had to go like 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 2, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 2, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know. That's a good one. Singing anything, dude. Like, can I do up a major third, down a half step, up a major third, down a half step, up a major third, down a half step, up a major third, down a half step to get from here to here like this? Yeah, that'd be going. Bo we do wa do we de do ba D flat C. I'm pretty in tune by the end, so it's all good. You know, I'll quiz myself on stuff like that all the time, because if you can sing that means you can hear it in your head. If you can hear it in your head, that means you can hear it in a song. You'll be able to match it to the thing that you, a reference that you have in your head. You'll be able to identify it. So those are just some simple ear training things I would do. But yeah, I think singing and listening are the two best things you can always, always do. That's the most holistic approach to ear training, is just be singing constantly, you know, and then be trying to guess, try to identify the things that you hear when you sing, or when you know, like, if you can't sing that, that means you probably can't hear it in your head, right? Well, if you can't hear it in your head, then when you hear it in a song, you might not know what that is. So make sure you can sing those things. You know? Yeah. All right, y'all. Say what's up in the chat one time, and then I'll say goodbye to everyone. So if you're here right now, as we do at the end of every single stream, everyone who's here, say what's up so I can acknowledge you and say thanks. Let's do it while we can, because once this gets out of control and we got, you know, 10,000 followers, I won't be able to say what's up to everybody. So let's do it. Devin Hu. Woo! What up, dude? Oh, time signature for Most Beautiful Girl is 9. We got Kles Mezers. We got Be Dead Low. We got They All Right. Thinking about getting a DX7, but not 100% sold. What kind of stuff do you use for it? Pads, leads, bass lines, everything. We got Weens 234, Jay Jaquison. I'd love to see you subscribe someday. We got Guyman 150, Chihu, Jay Joao. We got Joao. We got Wigmaster. What's up, dude? I'd like to see you subscribe sometime. We got Supreme Tortilla, Kles Smezers, NMM. We got Hen RSL 11, AD Lean. Audilene? I don't know. Choice Fun. What up, dude? Bubbly Water. What's good? Thanasis. Yasu. Kalispera. Dan Borgo. James D. McCool. What up, dude? PLSNTENKIU. Had to spell it because I can't pronounce it. Please and thank you. Wow, I could have just read that out. To Twomp Stomp. What up, dude? King Yak Yak. They all right. This is Jaybird. Jaybird, what up, dude? 1 bar 4, 1 bar 5. Pretty much. I guess you could think of it as like 5 first, but yeah, 4 and 5 put together. Jay Jaquison, Cause, Sleuth One, Jack F. Early, Nalaka means woke. What's up, South Africa? How's it going, dude? How's it going? We got Audi Lean. Like 80. 80 Lean. Oh. I can see that now. 240 KM Desmirne. Kate Gorakon. What up? They all right? What up? All right, y'all. I'm peacing out. Thanks so much for tuning in. And I'm going to just play the beat I made today while I peace out. All right, y'all. Wash your hands. Wash your hands, 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 wash your hands.